Hey everybody, Dr. Rob here. Why your diet isn't working. Why your diet isn't working. We got this weight loss trap. Man, oh man, I've been in this business for 17 and a half years, and all I see is people trying to lose weight. And the same people who try and lose weight are always trying to lose weight. And we actually know why weight loss is such a difficult thing to perform efficiently, to take weight off, one, and actually to keep weight off, number two. So I put together a whole bunch of things, and I want to go through them all. This was actually the lead in Time Magazine May 25th article. It just came out. It was as if they were speaking to me and I was looking in the mirror. Some other articles just recently came out in health.com and another magazine that I put in here, all leading to why weight loss traps and it's hard to do weight loss. Number one. Obesity, more preventable death than smoking. Obesity, we're at 40% for women in America. 35% of men in America are obese. When you really look at it, obesity causes more money, $66.3 billion, than so many other types of items. Obesity can go down a road that can cause a ton of chronic disease, cardiovascular disease, diabetes, cancer, musculoskeletal, depression, and the like. But when you really look at the fact that most people are heavy, it's why. They really don't know how to eat. They've tried to lose weight, they've gained it back. Some people have given up. Smoking, we all know, is deleterious to your health. Smoking, you usually lose about 10 years of your life. Yet if you're heavy, you lose more time in your life. And here's the big kicker. Your quality of life is adversely affected. So let's talk about some traps, let's talk about some solutions, and let me explain to you how everybody out there who wants to lose a few pounds, or lose a lot more than a few pounds, can do it efficiently and keep it off. The Biggest Loser results, this was great. Everybody remembers that show, my God, thank God for The Biggest Loser. We had 14 people, we actually had 16, but they followed 14 people afterwards. These 16 people were morbidly obese, they were heavy, they had a personal trainer, they were exercising, they were on a calorically restrictive diet, man, they were on a perpetual weight loss program. They got down, those guys got down to like what I weigh. They were 430 pounds and they got anywhere from 182 to 191. They were talking about them being physique models and everything like that. Of the 14 people they followed post Biggest Loser, 13 out of 14 are heavier now than they were before. Why? What happened? Well, one, obviously they didn't have 6 hours a day to work out. They couldn't afford a chef to cook their food and everything like that. The problem was their basic metabolic rate or their resting metabolic rate slowed down as they lost weight. Amazing. So at 400 pounds, as they lost this weight and they shrunk and they shrunk and they shrunk, their body required less calories. So at 190 pounds where they got to on average, which is about what I weigh, their basic metabolic rate or their resting metabolic rate was 600 calories less. So I could eat 600 calories more than they could to maintain their weight. They were hungry. Simply put, they were hungry. The math didn't work. And also right here, slimmer and hungrier. What happened was two different things happened to the brain. As they lost the weight, they attacked fat cells. Now, fat cells, believe it or not, do not like to get attacked, and they don't like to get shrunk. So here's what happened. Their fat cells spoke to their brain, and they shut off a hormone called leptin. And they turned on a hormone called ghrelin. Ghrelin is a hunger hormone, ghrelin. I've said this before. And people got not only hungrier because of the hormones, but they had no satiety, because when they decreased leptin, leptin led to satiety. They also just found out in health.com on May 24th, there's another enzyme in the brain that when fat cells are attacked and there's a scarcity of food, they release the enzyme and you got hungrier. So your basic metabolic rate decreased, so you needed less food than the average person at your weight, and your brain told you. You know what they also found out in that Biggest Loser? It takes 12 months to change your basic metabolic rate and 12 months to change your hormones and your enzymes in your brain. So there is no fast weight loss. So if you're looking to lose weight for vacation, 20 or 30 pounds, and not have it come back, cut a piece of your body off. It's just not gonna happen. The results are in. Then, They also found out exercise is critical for good health. I purport everybody should exercise, whether it's your 15,000 steps, your high interval intensity training, your steady state, get moving, move your body. Exercise is a key component. But what they found out was exercise is not a reliable thing or reliable method for long-term fat loss. So yes, I can put everybody on exercise. I can't tell you, as you guys all know, I practice. I can't tell you how many people said, I can lose the weight, all I need to do is exercise. No, you'll be healthier, and it's a good thing, and it's a part of the equation, but it's not gonna keep long-term fat loss off, and not unless you can work out 8 hours a day like a Lance Armstrong or Michael Phelps. It's just not gonna work. So exercise, but that's not your own overall end answer. Calories in, calories out, without question, is antiquated. Everybody counts calories. I don't want you counting calories anymore. It's an antiquated equation because if you're 300 pounds and you count the calories, you have to count the calories once again when you're 200 and you're not taking into account all the enzymatic reactions and the hormones that are working. It is antiquated. Don't count calories. Count chemicals. That actually, you've heard me say multiple times, and that actually was a lead story on health.com on May 24th. Don't count calories. Count chemicals. Don't count calories. Count nutritional value. Don't count calories. Count the amount of ingredients. Count satiety. Calories, if you count calories, it's antiquated. You're never going to lose weight. We're looking at everything else that affects the system. So that's an enormous takeaway. Do I get some brownie points, John, for getting that right? Everybody, do that for me. If you're going to do anything, give me a big thumbs up now and say hi and thanks and all that. Weight loss trap. 80% with obesity who lose weight gain it back. 8 out of 10. The numbers are not good. 8 out of 10. I want to keep reiterating that. It is a lifestyle change. It's in looking at everything. Genetics. Yeah, there is a genetic component. There's no doubt about it. I always said that we want to if genetics are an envelope, we want to stretch the envelope. We don't want to break it. What we found out, genetics does play a role. It plays anywhere from 10 to 30%. However, 70, 90% is controllable by you. And if I can help you. So understand you can test your genetics. There are specific genetic markers that we can look at. There are blood tests to see where you are, 23andMe, your genome, etc. Just because, say, your parents were heavy, you don't have to be heavy. If you saw my sister and I don't like to say this live, you would never think that we are brother and sister because our body structures are without question totally different. Chemicals. We talked about the chemicals. A great chemical to use an example is BPA. Now, BPA is everywhere. It's in the bottles, it's in the plastics, in the like. What we found with people who have a higher incidence or higher level of BPA, we have a higher incidence of obesity. We have a higher incidence of diabetes. We have higher incidence of weight gain. These chemicals are a major problem, BPA, because they mimic hormones and they block receptor sites in the body, and therefore they don't allow hormones to get broken down. Increased BPA shown to have a 47% increase in diabetes. So it's really, is it sugar or is it the chemicals and sugar? So we want to really watch and decrease our amount of chemicals, and that really leads us down the road, as we've talked about many times, about detoxing. So I will say this. If you're going to go on a body composition weight loss diet, a key component is to detox before and during your body composition time. So if you have any questions on detox, give me a call. I'm going to give you all the information on where to look to get all the answers for your weight loss needs. The microbiome, well, I can tell you this. We could be here for about 5 hours talking about the microbiome. Without question, in the last 3 years, it has captivated all the functional medicine audiences and people. I even see commercials on TV now talking about getting some yogurt and getting some good bacteria and some bad bacteria. So your microbiome, your gut, 70% of your immune cells are in your gut. It's where all your macro, your food, and micronutrients are absorbed. It's all about your good and bad bacteria. You guys saw a health tip I just did. You really want your good bacteria between 80 and 85%. Your bad bacteria should not be more than anywhere from 15 to 20. Any unleveling of that bacteria, the term is called dysbiosis, you will without question gain weight. There's been multiple studies to talk about probiotics, the microbiome and bacteria and weight gain. Great example were some mouses that they used. They had a thin and a heavy mouse. They took the thin mouse and they took the microbiome from the heavy mouse to the thin mouse. That thin mouse with no change in caloric intake, no change in activity levels, got heavy. They took the microbiome from the thin mouse and put it in the heavy mouse. No changes in all the things that I just mentioned. That mouse got thin. They've done that in humans. So without question, your microbiome is a key component to overall health. You gotta take a probiotic, you gotta have a good diet. So, I kind of laid out some of the problems. It's in all the literature now, it's in Time Magazine. Here's the solution. Solution is the key to weight loss is a highly personalized and individual diet and lifestyle. Personalized and individualized. That speaks to seeing someone like me who's a functional medicine, functional nutritionist, who's gonna personalize it and individualize it for you. I just gave a lecture last week and we asked what the best diet was. Well, the one thing we know, the worst diet is the standard American diet because we're all too heavy. Is the best diet keto? Is the best diet paleo? Is the best diet Mediterranean? The warrior diet? I don't know. It depends what your needs are. It depends what your genetics are. It depends where you are. John standing behind there and myself, we both have very good competent body fat. My man Chris, who's our other social media team member, he's lean, and we all have different diets because we all sat down and we individualized and personalized it for everything. My wife stays fit. I individualized and personalized it for her. All my patients get individualized and personalized. The best diet is the best diet that I will find, and we will work together to find what works for you. So what you want to do is, without question, you want to sit down, give me a call if you have any questions, find somebody, or call me if you're not in my local area and you can't do it virtual. I'll find you somebody. Let me know. You can email us or you can IM us at Facebook. And I will be talking about a diet with you, what tests you need, what diet will work best for you, what supplements, what probiotics. If you guys just want to go to my website, it's right here, www.drrobertsilverman.com. Let me say that again, www.drrobertsilverman.com. I have a shop. You can go right to my shop. You can click on my store. And if you do that in the next 7 days, you use the code RSilverman, you can get 20% off on your next purchase. John, you got any questions?
Yeah, a couple. Tell them some of the stuff they'll find in your store.
I'm sorry?
Some of the stuff that they will find in your store.
Some of the stuff. I have on my store 360 different supplements. So here are the ones that I would recommend. Number one, I would go for anything in the Ultra Flora line. What I like is I like the Ultra Flora Balance. Click and go for it. Ultra Flora Control is a great choice. They're both probiotics. They're going to help house and give you good bacteria. Phyto Multi is great. It's a multivitamin, multi-mineral, phytonutrient, Megagenics, EPA, DHA 720 is a great fish oil. And if you got any kind of concern about inflammation, and everybody probably does, Megagenics SPM is the way to go.
Talk a little bit about the mindset necessary to lose weight. These are a lot of the tactical things, yeah. But what should someone be thinking? What should their expectations be?
Yeah, it's a great point. Great question. Whoever asked that. The mindset is great. You have to understand that this is a life change. The problem that most people have is they want something really quick. I get it. Every patient says, can I have it today? I don't want to work hard, but you got nothing without your health. It's the most important thing. When you get there, you're able to keep it. So the mindset is to understand that you're going to go piecemeal, piece by piece by piece. You're going to layer off that fat. You're going to layer off that fat. Your energy level is going to increase. You're going to follow these protocols that are individualized and personalized for you. Remember, something I like to tell a lot of my patients, please give me reasons for success and avoid the excuses for failure. Because that's what champions do. They find reasons to succeed.
For the people who don't want to do a diet and just want to eat better, What are some of the low-hanging fruit that you would recommend?
Well, I don't believe in a diet. So we mentioned diet names. Diet has that jail term idea. So we don't like that. The lifestyle is what we're talking about. So what are we looking for? Let's say it right away. Let's do the GPS of health, my GPS. Let's avoid gluten. Let's avoid processed food. Let's avoid sugars and additive sugars. Those are great choices. Let's look at vegetables. Let's look at what our ancestors ate. Man, what they could eat 100 years ago is what we want to eat. What they could make 100 minutes ago is what we want to avoid. So grass-fed beefs, quality Atlantic, quality wild salmon, some free-range eggs, chicken, vegetables, natural nuts, you know, not roasted, almonds, pecans, things of that nature, grapefruit, avocado. Avoid your carbohydrates. Have some fruits. Look to berries. Look to apples and the like. And eat food throughout the day. Don't jump up on one big meal and do nothing so your blood sugar goes like this.
And if someone were to work with you on an individualized nutrition plan, can you just talk about what they can expect as a starting point?
Absolutely. The number one thing they're going to find as a starting point is they're going to have a plan. And a plan that is, use the term again, individualized and personalized for you. So we're going to find out what works best for you right away. Number two, you're going to get an education. I think the biggest problem is people don't know what to do for themselves. Number three, can give you a lot of recipes, can give you a lot of food lists. People walk out and go, I don't know what to eat, even though you told me. How do I make it? Where do I buy it? We're going to take care of all those different things. So we're going to individualize it, personalize it, and educate you so you feel comfortable and let you understand that you're on the road to success.
Awesome. Let people know where they can find you.
They can find me, and do me a favor, everybody. Like this. Let's like this. This is right in Time Magazine. This is without question, timely. Like this, share this with everybody. I'm looking for 50 shares. Just give me some 50 shares. What do you say? Give me 50 shares. You guys can find me right here on Facebook. You can find me at drrobertsilverman.com. Subscribe to my YouTube. See you every week. Always yours in health.com.